today I'll be talking about periodontal disease in dogs. This is most commonly called gum disease. So what it is, it's a harmful bacterial infection that eats away at the gums and the jawbone. The bacterial infection of the gum advances, the gum will begin to pull away from the tooth, and it creates a groove between the tooth and the gum, known as the periodontal pocket. These pockets favor the invasion of harmful types of bacteria and the bacterial toxins and inflammation attack and dissolve the architecture holding the tooth in its socket, such as the periodontal ligament and even the jawbone itself. So in this picture, you can just see like a large amount of plaque buildup in the teeth.
And that's the canine tooth right there. Point that out. I've never seen a canine tooth with that much debris on it.
I know. So there's four stages of periodontal disease, so it increasingly gets worse, obviously. Stage one, you have mild redness and inflammation of the gums, commonly known as gingivitis, and it's seen near the teeth, and you can see that through here, kind of red. Stage two, probing indicates periodontal pockets have formed between the gum and the tooth. Pockets over 3 millimeters in depth indicate abnormal gingivitis of the gums. So again, you can see around here. Stage three, the periodontal pockets are measured at deeper than 5 millimeters and the bone loss is observed. So there's stage three again. And then stage four, it's greater than 40 to 50% bone loss, extensive tartar buildup, and gum recession. So you can see like the difference between the gums here and the gums here, and the large mass of brown and gray. So how does your dog get periodontal disease? Obviously, our dogs don't brush their own teeth like we do, so when a dog eats, the bacteria in the mouth will form plaque, and your dog's immune system is going to recognize the plaque as foreign. So when your body of the dog senses a foreign invader, it marshals the white blood cells to attack. So in turn, the bacterial in plaque tells the white blood cells to release enzymes that break down the gum tissue. This leads to inflamed gums, destroyed tissue, and loss of bone, and the end result is you can lose your tooth. So a question I got when I was looking up, a lot of people ask, like in forums and stuff, are all dogs susceptible to this disease? And the answer is yes, but smaller dogs and Yorkies have a higher chance, as well as purebreds. That's just, again, with genetics, but in the end, all of them can. So that's just a picture of a little Yorkie. Symptoms of periodontal disease include bleeding or red gums. So again, right here, pawing at your mouth, so obviously discomfort, lack of appetite, meaning it's probably too painful to eat, difficulty eating, excessive drooling, irritability or antisocial behavior. Just like us, when we're sick and we don't feel well, we're kind of irritable. Loose or missing teeth, so you can see that maybe in their dog food or something like that. One of my dogs from a long time ago had a loose tooth and I ended up finding it in their food and was very concerned. blood in the water bowl or on chew toys, and then bad breath. Bad breath is usually what owners come in for and complain about when they go into the vet. So why is this a big deal? Periodontal disease can spread to the kidney, heart, and other organs via the bloodstream, making it very deadly. So if your dog has periodontal disease, the surface of the gum is weakened and compromised, and then the breakdown of your gum tissue is the portal through which your mouth bacteria enters the bloodstream. If the immune system doesn't kill off the bacteria circulating in the blood, it can reach the heart and infect it. There's a strong correlation between gum disease and
endocarditis.
There we go. And inflammation of the heart's valves or inner lining. So another way gum disease may lead to heart problems is that some types of the bacteria found in the dog's mouth produce sticky proteins, and these can adhere to the walls of the arteries. I don't know why every time it says the, it's her. As the bacteria builds up, it thickens the walls of the arteries and narrows the passageway through the arteries. Bacteria are also known to promote the formation of blood clots, which also can damage the heart. So prevention and treatment, you can brush your own dog's teeth, and you know, you have your own dog toothpaste, you don't use human's toothpaste. Another interesting thing, just to kind of build off the last presentation, was someone mentioned feeding a raw diet due to the natural flora in it. That can break down in the plaque around the dog's tooth. A good rule of thumb is to inspect your dog's teeth and gums just to make sure everything looks all right. With this disease, it's pretty noticeable, as you can tell in the picture, so that's something that you would know when you see it. And then professional teeth cleaning, which is going to your veterinarian and either having them or a vet tech or anyone who is available and professional enough to do it. A lot of times they can apply antibiotics beneath the gums, root planing, root canal, they can extract teeth, etc. And then again, here's just a picture of a teeth cleaning. So what happens during professional teeth cleaning? Veterinary dental cleaning also always begins with an initial awake oral exam of your dog. So you're just in the procedure room with them, and your vet will go over kind of what's going to happen and what's going to be done. And they'll also ask then if you're okay with any teeth being extracted, as it usually is an additional cost. Your pet has blood drawn for analysis just to identify if there's any problems that they shouldn't be under anesthesia. Then a veterinary technician will most likely place a catheter to deliver drugs and fluids during the procedure, or like a pre-medication injection can be given for relaxation and pain relief. And then a breathing tube is placed through your dog's mouth into the trachea, and this tube just ensures an open airway during the procedure through which oxygen and anesthetic gas can be delivered, and it prevents the liquids and bacteria in the mouth from entering the airway and lungs. As you can see in the picture, here's a before and after. So this is before the cleaning. You can tell there's a lot of plaque buildup, and then here's after. The teeth are nice and white. The gum line is very noticeable. So there is a huge benefit of having your dog's teeth cleaned. This is just continued. Some veterinary clinics will begin with a x-ray if needed. You can rinse the mouth. You know, the dental plaque and tartar are removed using tools. And then a special periodontal scaler is used to clean along and just under the gum line, as that's where the oral bacteria can do most damage. After that's complete, they'll use a periodontal probe to look for signs of the periodontal disease and any other abnormalities. And then the vet will go through and look at the x-rays and look at the teeth. If anything needs extracted, I think that's when they will let their technician know. If there are no extractions or special treatments needed, the tech will go on to polish the teeth with a rubber-tipped rotary polishing tool and paste. Polishing smooths the surface of the tooth to make it more difficult for plaque to become adhered. And then the mouth is rinsed and dried, and a fluoride foam can be placed on the teeth at the end of the procedure. And then here's just a good healthy x-ray, and then there is, again, your dental x-ray.
Yeah, I like the comparison photos.
Yeah, they show a lot.
The bad, the before and after. Does the audience have any questions, comments?
It's just the hardy ones left here.
I know.
Yes.